Hi friends, welcome back. Friends, today's video is focused on Paradise Lost, most appreciated work of John Milton and most appreciated work in history of English literature. Yes friends, this is an epic poem by John Milton, and in this video we are going to cover key facts about the poem Paradise Lost and also some important characteristics of the epic poem and also form and structure of this specific poem of English literature, that is an epic poem Paradise Lost. Yes friends, if you are visiting first time, please do not forget to subscribe this channel, because you will get here the most important content of English literature in a very informative way. So let's move on to the topic of the day, Paradise Lost. And friends, let's discuss the key facts of the poem, epic poem Paradise Lost. And the first, we have the full title of this poem is Paradise Lost. It was written around 1558 to 1663. Because it was epic poem, it was the grand poem of the John Milton. It was the magnum opus of John Milton. That's why it took 6 years, five, 6 years to compose this poem by John Milton. And after, when John Milton became blind, he composed this poem. उन्होंने ये poem after his blindness, अपने blindness जब वो blind हो चुके थे तब ये poem उन्होंने compose करी हुई है. And it was written in London, England. The first time it was published with 10 books in 1667 में first time ये publish हुई थी. And it has the number of 10 books के साथ ये publish हुई. Later on it was revised, and the revised edition of this Paradise Lost book came in the year 1674 with the two more books के साथ में ये आई, सेकेंड एडिशन इसका आया जब 1674 में. देन इट हैज़ टोटल 12 नंबर्स ऑफ बुक्स विच ऑल अदर्स एपिक पोएम मस्ट हैड. एंड द लिटरेरी पीरियड, इट वॉज रिटन ड्यूरिंग द टाइम ऑफ लेट English Renaissance and also English Restoration period, because in the year 1660 the Restoration period was started in England. 1660 mein Restoration period start hua tha, and this at that time Milton was composing this poem. That's why the two main literary periods was during the time when Milton had written this poem, this epic poem, this magnum opus of John Milton or of English literature. And the genre of this poem is epic poetry. Yes friends, this poem had a grand style, and it has the all elements of the epic poem. That's why this is the category of the poem poetry. And also Christian mythologies. The setting of this poem is heaven, hell and paradise. All the description, whatever the stories, whatever the described by the John Milton, that is related to the heaven, hell and paradise. And the climax of this poem, this epic poem, is this: Eve eats the forbidden fruit from the tree of knowledge. जो ट्री ऑफ नॉलेज होता है उससे वो फॉरबिडन फ्रूट को टेस्ट कर लेती है, ईट कर ले, खा लेती है, ऑन स्पाइट ऑफ द गॉड्स ऑर्डर, गॉड के ऑर्डर के बावजूद, बिकॉज गॉड हैड ऑर्डर नॉट टू टेस्ट द फ्रूट ऑफ from the tree of knowledge. But Eve, when Satan tempted her, Satan usko tempt kar leta hai, and under that temptation she takes the fruit of knowledge from the tree of knowledge. And this was the climax of the poem. Now let's discuss the form and structure of the poem, of this epic poem Paradise Lost. We have in the introduction of the poem, Milton himself says that the format is English heroic verse without rhyme. And this, what is the heroic verse? The heroic verse is used for the epic and heroic subjects. That's why in the Paradise Lost, Milton has used this epic verse, heroic verse, without rhyme. There was no rhyming scheme, and they are not rhyming. There are no rhyming couplets. And in other words, blank verse. Yes, friends, it was written in blank verse. This was the poem written in blank verse. And it was written in iambic pentameter. But there is no rhyming scheme. यहाँ पे कोई rhyming scheme नहीं होती है. और ये iambic pentameter में लिखी गई poem है by John Milton. Friends, let's discuss more about epic poem Paradise Lost. Paradise Lost is an epic poem written in 17th century by the English poet John Milton. Let's move on. We have the first line of the epic, the poem Paradise Lost confirms that the poem's main focus will be of man's first disobedience. Yes, friends, this is the opening line of the poem, of the great epic poem of English literature, Paradise Lost, of man's first disobedience. And that Milton's aim to justify the ways of God to men. This was the last line of the opening stanza. And how Milton has said he targeted his focus, his main motive to compose this epic poem. In the very first stanza of the epic poem, of man's first disobedience, and the fruit of that forbidden tree whose mortal taste brought death into the world. This was the opening line of the Paradise Lost, and justifies the ways of God to men. This was the last line of the first stanza of the opening line of the poem Paradise Lost. And Milton's aim was to justify the ways of God to men. It was published in 1667, and Paradise Lost basically recreates the biblical story of the fall of man, mostly taken from the book of Genesis. Yes, friends, ये बहुत ही important facts से related, इस epic poem से related. This was the mostly taken the most things related to the biblical story. ये biblical story से based on है जो poem इन्होंने लिखी हुई है. And the fall of man, that was mostly taken from the book of Genesis. This was the first book of Bible in Old Testament, known as the name by name Book of Genesis. And in 1667 he published this book, and most of the stories focused on the biblical stories of the first book of Genesis. Paradise Lost was published in 1667. It has total number of 10,000 and more lines long. It was broken up into 10 books, and later edition it was broke it into 12 in 1674. Yes, friends, I already explained it that this book was first published in 1667 with the 10 books, number of 10 books, and later on the second edition of this book came into 1674 with the total number of books 12, which all important epic poem had. Now let's discuss the important characteristic of this epic poem Paradise Lost. And the very first we have sublimity of subject matter and style. Yes, friends, sublimity is related to the subject matter that Milton is talking about, the fall of man. He is going to write an epic poem related to the fall of man and how he justifies the ways of God to man. And that's why this is the subject matter of the epic poem. And next we have universality of theme. Yes, friends, we have so many themes involved in this epic poem by John Milton. We talk about that there was the disobedience theme, also sin, also there was a war kind of themes are involved in this revolt against God. This was the main themes involved in this epic poem Paradise Lost. Unity of action is related to the all the events, all the stories which are described in this epic poem. All the events, they all are connected with one another, so there is no kind of things that was unconnected with one story from the other. They have a kind genuine connection, they have a logic connection. That's why it has the unity of action. This was the important characteristic of this epic poem. And it has also, next we have the beginning, middle and end. Yes, friends, this poem, epic poem, has beginning, its middle and its end, because the story he was talking about the fall of man, how God has forbidden, how the Eve and Adam was enjoying their life in heaven, but after their when they or obeys the order of God, then how they were expelled from the heaven, and how Satan and Lucifer, they were expelled from the heaven, and later on how they regained it. It was the, so it all has a beginning, middle and end. Next we have invocation of to God. Yes, friends, this is very important characteristic of an required for an epic poem, and this was also had in Paradise Lost. Milton was invoking God. वो invoke करता है, वो God को pray करता है, because he is going to write a subject matter which is very grand. No one has ever attempted to write any kind of stories, any kind of poem related to this. That's why he is invoking to God. वो invocation कर रहा है, वो God को से प्रार्थना कर रहा है that please God help me to write to compose this poem. I need your help to compose a poem which I am going to describe in this poem. Next, he is talking about the characteristic council of war speeches of elaborate length. Yes, friends, whatever the war scenes described in this poem, composers in this poem or mentioned in this poem, they all have the very brilliant speeches and they all have elaborated speeches. Extensive use of epic simile, metaphors and classical allusions. This was also the one important characteristic of the poem Paradise Lost. And the epic simile is related to the elaborate comparisons that travels beyond the point of comparison and gives a complete poetic picture of the some scene. Yes, friend, epic simile is related to the poetic picture described by the poet, and it thinks it imagine the poet, the who person who was reading, who are reading this poem or who are reading this kind of poem or Paradise Lost, they have the real picture of that scene before their eyes. That's why it has the epic simile, metaphors and classical allusions. Also, it has grand style because it has an epic poem. That's why it must have a grand style, and the Paradise Lost have a grand style. Human interest in this epic poem, Milton is talking about human interest. Don't disobey God orders. God ke, don't go against God. God ke against mat jao. You will get its result when you will go against God, as happened with the Eve and Adam. And next, a moral tone. It was human interest is related to the story about the human beings and how Adam and Eve suffered a lot after they are expelled from the heaven. And also moral tone is this, that do not go against the God, please obey God orders. This was the main important characteristics of this poem Paradise Lost. So friends, this was all we had discussed here about characteristics, about the important facts of Paradise Lost, which was an epic poem by John Milton. And in our next video, we will also cover important themes, what are the themes involved in this epic poem, and also the most important characters, how they behaved in this, how they was treated in this epic poem Paradise Lost. And also we will also cover this summary of this epic poem Paradise Lost. So friends, please stay connected with English Zone for the more informative videos of English literature. Thank you very much for watching this.